In this series of flights, I'm doing some practice with launching really low. So I'm doing 2 to 3 second motor runs, and I'm trying to hook up as low as possible. So for the rules, you can have a full 30 second motor run, and the start altitude is 10 seconds after the motor shuts off. So I'm practicing a little bit of that too. So I launched, pretty much started turning at the top of the launch about, you know, 10, 12 meters, 30, 35 feet or so. This thermal's moving pretty fast down the field, even though the wind's very calm, it's moving pretty quickly down. There's another launch. You can see how low I launched, very short motor run. I felt some air right off. As I launch, I can just feel good energy there, so I'm kind of exploring with the motor off. Now, you could do this with the motor on, of course. See, I'm kind of getting low. I can feel the energy there, so I can get a lower start altitude, but not too low, because I know there's definitely a ceiling pretty much below 30 feet. It's very difficult to thermal out in these particular conditions, even though it's a nice sunny day and it's pretty calm. See, there's a pretty strong little column right there. When I changed directions, just felt better that I should swap over, go counterclockwise instead. I look at the altitude gains right away. Another launch, just a few seconds of motor. See the drift to the right, big time, so I know there's probably some air there. I can feel the air is kind of dead enough, so I don't want to risk going lower than my launch height. Oh, even though I did do a little turn down just to feel the energy, but you can see how fast the plane's going, so that kind of tells you there's some energy there. So at the end of the 10 seconds of the motor run, I get, you know, a lower start altitude. But again, you're weighing the risks of falling out of that thermal. This one's getting a little dicey down low, as you can tell. It's not looking great on some of those turns. Staying with it. Just kind of working the trashy bottom of this thermal. And I'm walking to follow the plane back towards the field boundaries. That's what you do in a contest. Oh, now it's starting to pop a little bit. It's moving off to the southwest of the field. And that's pretty much a taker. Can take that one out pretty easily. So once I got above a certain level, you can see the climb rate really increases. You know, very marginal at 10 to 12 meters, 30, 35 feet. There's thermal 4. You can see it's pretty dead right there. You see how the plane just kind of right off the launch is pretty unresponsive. I had a little bit of a wind shift pointing that direction, so I'm going to explore that. I'm feeling good energy. See how the plane's speeding up? That means there's definitely some thermal there, and how low can I take it out? So I would have gotten a pretty low start altitude from that, but again, you're weighing the risks not being able to, you know, get into the stronger part of the thermal. It felt pretty good, and away I go. Just being smooth, not doing aggressive turns, just trying to feel where the thermal is going to move. Since there wasn't much predominant wind, thermals were kind of moving all over the place. So you're just coming in for a relight. You know, say this was a short task, say 1 minute, 1 minute 30 task. See if I can get back on that same thermal. Should be right about there. Again, your start altitude does count. So you can see the, you know, that was only a 2 second motor run, but the collider's maintaining pretty good energy there, so I know that thermal's still there someplace. As I went to my right, it didn't feel very good. back. There we go. Again, walking towards the plane because I have to relight. This gives me kind of a better angle on reading the plane down this low. I can feel the flow going more to my left, so I'm following it there, and that's where the strongest part of the core was. So we're starting to build there. So I could probably launch into that thermal again. Look how strong it is now. So if this was even a 2-minute task, I could probably come back down and relight into it. Number 5, low level. Now, not every time I was launching this low was I taking the thermals out. You're just kind of seeing the best of this particular session. Okay, you can see me kind of circling, feeling out the lift, how strong it is. And even down low, you can see the plane's maintaining energy. I do not have the motor on. That's only for the initial altitude. So once I feel the energy start to dissipate, I'll convert some of that speed to altitude. Here's 6. Close in right here, had a little bit of a wind shift read right there, but it wasn't real strong and it wasn't 100% either. It's very light. Now this one was light enough, so I didn't want to waste any of my start altitude by going lower, so I would just take that altitude start reading there, but it's still pretty low. But the lower part of the thermal was soft enough, so I didn't want to risk it. Feel it was there, just wasn't quite bringing a strong flow in down low. But just had to be patient. I was maintaining altitude, but I really wasn't climbing, as you can see. Again, just following the energy, probing around, probing the edges. Eventually, I start getting into a stronger bit of it. Now I'm pretty safe, and I can definitely take that one out. But it's pretty far away. So here's another low level. The last one. Didn't feel really good off the launch where I had the initial read, so I quickly went somewhere else. Starting to feel the energy. Plane circling with good amount of energy. This is not with the motor on again. I knew there's something there. Got a pretty good low start altitude reading. Now I'll trade some of that energy for a little bit of altitude, make sure I don't get pushed out the bottom of the thermal, or I just kind of miss where it's going. But those things you learn, it's just a lot of practice. So practice.